And so it were wisest to keep our feet from wandering into complaining street, and never to growl whatever we do, lest we be mistaken for grumblers too. Let us learn to walk with a smile and a song, no matter if things do sometimes go wrong, and then be our station high or humble, we will never belong to the family of grumble. Welcome to the last video, students. We are nearing the last part of the poem. Once again, I want to recapitulate what we have told in the previous videos shortly. First of all, we studied that the grumblers, they live in the place of complaining street. Their city is called Never Satisfied, and they live near the river of discontent, dissatisfaction. And even though they have many things with them, they find that it is not enough, and they even go to the extreme of complaining about nature. They complain about whatever they find for the whole day. They cannot live for even a single day without complaining about anything. Then in the previous two stanzas, we studied that no grumbler will accept that he belonged to the grumbler's family. And recently we studied that if we spend time with the grumblers, we too will become a grumbler. These are the things we have discussed in the previous videos. Now we are in the last part of the poem. These two stanzas speak of the suggestions of the poetess in order to get rid of the grumbling and escaping from the grumblers. The first suggestion given by her is that keeping away from them. We studied that they live in complaining state. We should not have any contact with them, and as much as possible we should try to cut the contact from the grumblers. This way we can safeguard ourselves from grumbling. Another suggestion is that we should not growl. Growl means finding fault. We do lot of things in our daily life. As much as possible, we should be positive in our attitude. We should never try to find fault in our activities, and we should never find fault in activities done by others. If we do find fault, then we will be mistaken for a grumbler. Others will think us grumblers. We should keep in mind these two things very strongly. Then, what is the thing? How should we face life? How we can safeguard ourselves from grumblers? The very last suggestion given by her, how to approach life positively, is that we should try to see the positive thing in everything. There are two sides for everything in life, positive and negative side. We should always focus on the positive side of things. Then it is natural that sometimes problems come. Sometimes what we expect cannot happen. Sometimes we cannot get the results that we have expected. We should understand that these are common in everybody's life, and then we should try to see the positive side of these things. This way we can safeguard ourselves. And I would like to give a small example. There was a religious speaker. He was speaking about Thiruvilayadal. You would have heard of that. Thiruvilayadal tells about Lord Shiva and his wife, Lordess Parvathi, and Lord Shiva's son, Lord Muruga, and others. Then he was giving a speech. After the speech, he asked a question about Thiruvilayadal. There were a lot of people, elders, middle-aged people, and then children. The speaker always has a habit of questioning the children, and if they gave the correct answer, he would give them small prize. Like that, he asked a question from Thiruvilaiyadal. He asked, "Boys, who is the father of Lord Muruga?" There was a boy in the crowd. He had watched the cinema Thiruvilaiyadal. I think you are also aware of that. In the Thiruvilaiyadal film, Lord Shiva's character was taken by famous actor Shivaji Ganesan, and actor Shivakumar. He acted as a son of Shivaji Ganesan. The boy who was in the crowd had watched the film Thiruvilaiyadal. He, instead of giving the answer Lord Shiva, he told in interest Shivaji Ganesan. He told that the father of Lord Muruga is Shivaji Ganesan. Everybody laughed. But the religious speaker, he was an aged person, he encouraged the boy, "Don't laugh." He gave the correct answer, "Come dear." He invited the boy and he gave some praise to the boy. And he also gave the explanation for the boy's answer. So people, don't laugh at him, he is correct. What he told, instead of telling Lord Shiva, he told Shivaji. He gave the correct answer. People were surprised. How Shivaji is the correct answer? The speaker explained. See, what is the real name of Gandhi? Gandhi is the correct name. Then Nehru is the correct name. But why do we call Gandhi as Gandhiji, Nehru as Nehruji, Netaji? Why do we have the practice of calling them? It is for respect. Instead of telling Gandhi, if you say Gandhiji, we are giving respect. Instead of telling Nehru, if you say Nehruji, it is a term of respect. So Shiva is the name of God. If he simply says Shiva, it is like insulting the God. So he told correctly Shivaji. Like that, the speaker justified the boy's answer. In fact, the boy is wrong, but he saw the positive side of the boy and encouraged him. This is the attitude we must develop. If we have the positive attitude in life, then we will not complain about everything. This is the message we are getting from the poem, The Grumble Family. Thank you, students.